Now, someone is confused out there saying, who is going to make sure that, you know, these awards do not have politics involved? It is simple. The more you request for your favorite artist's song on your MTN Caller Tune account, is the more your artists get the ratings, and the better for them to win 2.5 million at the end of every month. Do not forget that every Caller Tune is 550 Uganda shillings. Plus, also, there's that cap free package you can use to also get a Caller Tune every month. Is a free package you can get yourself. What's your Caller Tune?
Well, my Caller Tune right now is not Ugandan.
Is that Ugandan? Why?
Well, because I rarely receive calls. Yes. So yeah. Digital, that it's either almost WhatsApp, yeah. Twitter, email. So the number of calls I receive are very few. So
they're like one, two.
I mean, the first call I got today was from you. The last one, I think.
Okay.
Let me actually just add, I think you might have forgotten to mention that the customer too stands a chance of being rewarded with 1 million Uganda shillings and some Huawei devices. So it's not only the artists who are winning things, it's also you, the customer. So just follow those instructions and vote for, you know, download your favorite caller tune. I think you can use *170# to find the menu and then just follow the instructions. It's all pretty simple and you can just download your favorite caller tune.
What's your Ugandan favorite caller tune?
I think mine, let me go with Baby Cool Love You Every Day.
Oh.
Why not?
So it's fair like that. Just get your favorite and download it. But let me ask here, who was the favorite photographer at the photo market?
Well, it's hard to say because different people had different tastes. We had Mohsen Taha. Mm. He takes amazing street art. He has very beautiful photos of the city from different vantage points. We had Max Burr taking some very, you know, she's a lady, because when you, first time I had her name, I thought she was a guy, but she's a lady, and she has very beautiful photography. Sylvia Bamusime did some great light photography. There was one where she had spent two nights trying to get the perfect shot. It's about a bicycle, and it has just light trails all over it.
Now the next question, as Kay, you give me some of the photos there, is going to determine whether someone could choose a career in photography or not.
Yes.
How much do these photographs go for?
Well, you could actually buy the photographs at 100,000 shillings, each copy.
Is that the lowest or the highest they can go
That's for? The lowest. I mean, that's the actual price right now, because it's a photo market, so basically have everything at the same price. The idea is basically to bring out the photographers to the forefront, because before this year, I'm not sure very many people knew about Mohsen Taha, Lauren Paylor, because these are very good photographers. And the idea is, if you can bring them out there, you can know about them, you can even schedule with them. And
now, personally, I know some photographers that didn't take part in the Kampala photo market. I'd like to put it past your social media kind of awareness, but do you think, are you comfortable with the number of photographers that attended, or do you feel like some more should have attended but didn't?
Right now, we would have loved more photographers, but the idea, what was keeping us back right now is that we're still looking for a space which is able to accommodate more than 10. Because you know there are amazing photographers out there who would want to participate.
Can I take a photo with my phone and come showcase?
Well, let's talk about
If someone saw a photo from my phone, they'll be like, no, that's too cheap to be 100K. But
well,
hey.
Well, it depends, I think, because some people do very amazing photography
Absolutely.
From their phones.
And that brings up an interesting discussion that I think is a whole other show on its own.
Yes.
But photographers getting on Instagram, like social media device such as Instagram, how it can, first of all, take away business from photographers and also supplement the photographers themselves, because, you know, it's...
Yes, actually, there's a gentleman who did, I think what he did was, he went on Instagram and got people's photos, and he actually did a photo exhibition. He just changed the captions, and there was a case about it, because what happened was he didn't ask permission.
Yeah.
And he made a lot of money off of...
But that's a very interesting concept. I think that's very interesting.
Yes.
Do I need permission to use, you know, I thought when you post a photo on Facebook, it ceases to be yours.
But think about it now.
Yes.
Somebody goes onto your Facebook
and
page and takes pictures of you eating your matoke and beans.
And he sells it.
And sells it saying, you know, you get mad, wouldn't you?
Okay, let us scroll through some of the photos.
Well,
you
I
have.
Think it's beautiful. Like some of the pictures that I'm seeing, because you might not be able to see them very clearly behind me, but you can see the frames are very beautiful frames. I think that goes partly into the costs, and they're very great decorative pieces as well. So I think it's very interesting, and the people who went looked very happy with the event. But perhaps a good question would be, how many pieces did you actually sell that day?
From our calculation so far, we have I think over 40 pieces sold. Because what happens is, I think we have, everybody has sold at least a photo so far. And some have sold maybe three, some have sold maybe four, five. So, I mean, there's been a lot of sales going on. In fact, we were hoping to invite people back to our offices because, I mean, to get some more of those photos, they're still up for sale, though. But, yeah, there are many sales so far, and we want more sales. Not really for us. But for the we want to proliferate the Ugandan, you know.
Yes.
You have a home, you have an office. We'd like to come and find Ugandan photographers.
Yeah.
In the Urban TV offices. You know,
now that's a challenge. As I say now, let me just give a piece of advice to everyone whose sitting room is full of those, you know, those typical white soap opera actors.
Yes.
Like the blonde child.
Yes. Like to you out there, apart from Jesus. Let all other photos in your house be Ugandan.
Exactly.
They are this patriotic like
exactly.
that. Yes, my name is Willis, and I'm Willis at Willis Daily on Twitter. But also, MTN should come up with something close to a caller tune for people who don't call because he uses data. Let him use a profile picture of an artist, and the more profile pictures
you
get to see.
Or a hashtag.
Exactly. Anyway, the Caller Tune Awards have started. October, we have five people. There's Rema, there's Eddie Kenzo, there's Ziza Bafana, and I keep forgetting.
King Saha.
Then there's Bebe Cool, and there's, of course, David Lutalo. These five artists have been nominated, and they'll be taking home 2.5 million Ugandan shillings. And like Kay said, you can also take home 1 million if you keep requesting for a Caller Tune. Yes? Uh-huh. Neo is also going to be in the country on the 30th of October. Some of you are calling the guy Neo. But keep tuned to Urban TV and do not forget that the hashtag early updates start at 10 a.m.